learning to airbrush, there are a few things you've got to know how to do and feel really, really comfortable with. One is taking your airbrush apart. The other one is fixing a bent needle, because I guarantee you, if you play with this hobby for any length of time, you're going to bend needles all the time. And the answer is not just, oh, I'll just replace the needle, because that'll start getting expensive really quick, because needles are delicate and they get bent all the time. So let me show you the way to do it correctly. The first thing I want to talk about is really, what are we talking about when we're talking about a bent needle? Well, when you take the needle out of an airbrush, the tip of it can get bent very, very easily. And it's very difficult to see. That's why I kind of blew it up. But for an airbrush to work really, really well, this needle tip needs to be perfectly straight, because as you pull it back out of the nozzle, the space opens up around it. So the straighter the needle, the better your airbrush will work, and the finer the detail, and just the better overall performance you'll have. So what a bent needle can look like is, most likely if you've just banged up against the side or something, it'll bend just a little bit. It can actually hook all the way around and do all sorts of funky stuff if you hit it really hard. The trick is you need to get it to this point. Now, if you've hooked it all the way around, you might as well take a pair of pliers to it and try to bend it out to about like this, at least to begin with. Because worst that can happen is it's going to break and you're going to need a new needle anyway. But it's worth a shot. So the starting point you need to get to is at least to here, when the needle is just bent a little bit. At that point, now I can show you how to get it to a much, very honed in, very straight point. As you start to work on straightening your needle, you're actually doing two things. You're straightening the needle itself, and then you're also polishing the edge of the needle to make the actual transition as it goes from fat to skinny very, very smooth. And that's where you get into more of a polishing technique, and is really important for super, super fine, really nice airbrushes, because that can make a difference. For your run-of-the-mill, beginner airbrushes and things, the polishing part is not that critical. It's just important that the needle is straight itself. The way we're going to straighten out our needle is we're going to use a piece of cardboard. Now, believe it or not, I actually choose cardboard for a really good reason, because cardboard actually can polish metal very well. And it works for not only straightening your airbrush, but polishing it out a little bit. You can get into and use polishing cloths and things like that if you need super, super detail. But for the level of most of us are on, and the level I'm on, cardboard works great. Now, it is important that once you get a piece of cardboard, you understand how this cardboard is laid out. This is just a piece of cardboard, a flap off a cardboard box. But what's important about it is, on the inside, there are little cells that go back and forth in a piece of cardboard. You want to straighten your needle with those cells, not against them. How in the world do you tell? You just look in the end, or you can feel. Understand that a cardboard will bend with the cells, and it has a hard time bending against the cells. So you want to go in the same direction that it bends easily in. Okay? So we're going to go in this direction right here. So the technique that I'm going to show you that I think is the easiest way to fix a bent airbrush needle is, I'm going to place a little bit of pressure on the end of the needle and hold up the back side of the needle. And what I'm really doing is making the angle that comes off the end of the needle completely flush with the cardboard. Okay? As I do this, I'm going to rotate the needle a little bit, and I'm going to pull it backwards like this. All right? And I'm rotating nice and easy. And what it's doing is it's truing or straightening the end of that airbrush needle. Now, I'm not actually covering the tip with my finger, because I want you to be able to see what I'm doing and understand that the motion is pulling it back and turning it at the same time. I actually like to put my finger over the tip so I can get a good feel of it and make sure that I'm not overly bending or putting too much pressure on the tip. Because yes, you can break the tip off. And all I'm doing is I'm pulling that needle backwards and rotating it at the same time. Notice that I'm not pulling up very far on my needle at all, because what I want is this angle at the end of the needle to be flush with the cardboard. I don't want it to be too much. You'll just sit there and bend the end of your needle. And I don't want it not enough, because if I push down right now, it'll bend the end of the needle down. I want it flush with the cardboard. Now, the back part of your needle, you can put a little bit of pressure on, and it's usually not going to bend because it's obviously much thicker. So, trick is I'm just straightening it out, pulling backwards, and rotating it at the same time. And yes, it's an art. You need to take your time to make sure that you're doing it right. All right, just continue to do that until you have a really good, true point on your needle. And what's cool, as I told you, cardboard will actually help polish the end of your needle also. So take your time as you're learning to do this so you don't break your needle and you don't overly bend it. Because if you start putting too much pressure, what'll end up happening is as you rotate it, you'll bend it back and forth as it rotates, and the tip of it will just break off. So try not to do that, obviously. And just get the hang of it. Very, very light pressure, pull it back, and true the end of the needle. Now, how in the world do I know once I've got it trued? Well, it's actually pretty simple, but you do have to zoom way in and really look close. Now that I've pulled my needle and I've honed the tip of it, I need to check to see if it's perfectly true. The easiest way I've found to be able to do this is now you place it flat on a surface, like the surface of your cardboard is fine, all right? And then you're going to rotate it with your finger. And as you rotate it with your finger, you're going to look right there at the tip. If you see it move back and forth, it's still not true. But if it stays perfectly still as you spin it, that means it's perfectly true, okay? So I'm spinning it right now, nice and slow, and I'm looking at the tip. And if you notice, the tip doesn't move back and forth. That tells me that it's perfectly true. Now, for my airbrushing experts out there, which I know there are a few, you are looking for a super, super true point. So you need to actually pick it up, stick it on the end of your finger, and then rotate it and look to see if it's absolutely perfect. On a smaller airbrush, not such a big deal, but on a really, really super high detail airbrush, this is a big deal. And you're looking for that perfect, true tip. So when it comes to straightening out a bent tip on an airbrush, that's pretty much it. The trick is to take your time. There are several different techniques out there, and I'm not saying that they don't work. I'm just showing you this is one technique that is simple, and it has always worked for me. Now, just like I said, these techniques get exponentially a little bit more difficult when the nicer the airbrush, because the tolerances for a super, super high detailed airbrush start to get smaller and smaller. So this technique needs to really be honed down. And now you're not just talking about straightening out the needle of your airbrush, you're talking about polishing the tip so there's no imperfections in it. So remember, if you got any questions, you know where to check us out, airbrushtricks.com. I'm Tony D.